My name is David Wood Sr., and I, along with my sons, David Woods Jr. and Devin Woods, would like to invite you to join us for the next half hour as we present Dayton People. Now, it's a reality show that showcases people like yourself going about their everyday activities. So now, sit back, relax, and enjoy the program.
Hello there, this is David Woods Jr., producer of Dayton People. Dayton People is a reality show of women in Dayton, Ohio, going about their everyday activity. The show was created by me, David Woods Jr., my father, David Woods Sr., and my brother, Devin Woods. We would like for you to also check us out on YouTube and also check us out on other stations like the Christian stations and other stations. So we would like for you to sit back, relax, and enjoy the program. Thank you.
Robert, I'd like to take this time to invite you and your family to join me for Dayton People. And I, along with my son, Devin Woods, would like to introduce you to some of the people of the Dayton area going about their everyday activities. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the program. Did you hear about those lucky winners of $500 million?
Yeah, I heard them.
Man, can you believe that? They don't have a care from now on. They can just sit back, relax, and enjoy all the money. I'm happy for them.
Happy for them? I ain't happy for them. Why you happy for them? I ain't happy for them.
You're not happy for them?
Why would we happy for them? I'm at the welfare office, riding a skateboard, trying to get a number from the welfare lady. She looked at me in that discouraged, looked like, brother, you need to turn to the retarded place. And then they got a nice woman. They can afford a nice, good-looking woman, a Holly Berry kind of woman,
Essence
woman.
But aren't you happy for them? I mean, it could have been you, and they may have been happy for you, too.
I don't care if they're happy for me. I'm happy for myself, but I ain't happy for them. I don't want them doing better than me, get a better-looking woman than me, get more milk and cookies than me.
David, you shouldn't feel like that.
I bet you all America feel like that. I'm up here looking in the refrigerator, looking for some milk, and the only thing I see is a carton there with no milk. I go in there, see the bologna. The bologna is only one or two bologna in there with no bread.
Oh.
I cook the bacon on the George Foreman grill. Next thing I know, I burn the bacon, look for the Miracle Whip, and the Miracle Whip like that. I look like the oddest Miracle Milk.
Well,
and then they up there eating the gourmet dinner, eating lobsters, got proper maids and all that. Pretty women swimming in the swimming pool. My swimming pool is going in a lake on Lakeview Estates.
Oh, okay. Well, I thought maybe you would have a happy feeling for them.
I ain't happy for nobody doing better than me.
David.
Anybody, I happy for myself doing good. Now, I'm happy for somebody that they related to me because I'm going to get the money.
Oh.
Or if it's a woman of mine and she going to marry me and I got a wedding ring and she wanted that, and I'm very happy because that means I'm off the welfare ticket forever.
Well, that's true.
But
that's
I ain't happy for them. They going to have better than me, better life than me. I ain't happy for y'all. If y'all want to I ain't happy for one of y'all. I don't care if y'all want it or don't win. Unless y'all give me some money, unless you're a rich woman and you got money to pay the ladies' man to be with you, then we happy for you. Because that means you're going to buy us a Mercedes, a red car.
A red car.
A beautiful maid that looks beautiful when you out of town
for
us. So she do more than cleaning. And buy us a diamond ring, pay for everything. But if you ain't paying enough for the ladies' man, because we the ladies' man, Dean Ohio, and you got all that money, we don't get the money, we ain't happy for it.
David, do you think she would go along with your recommendations?
I think so. She needed to look a picture of me and you. See, we the best looking men in Dayton, Ohio.
Well, I don't know about that, but
we told them we at the welfare office. So you know, the 500, the people won that big lottery.
Mm-hmm.
If you a woman in this bunch, and you got all that money, come down to Dayton, Ohio, cause the ladies men here. You can go ahead and pay for our new shoes. We like Jordans, all kind of Jordans. Every Jordan, even Jordan ain't been out yet.
Okay.
You can buy Dad a tuxedo and a brand new Bible.
I would like that.
And you can pay for me to go to the welfare office and laugh that I ain't gonna get no more food stamps.
But that would be something great to know that for the rest of your life, you would never have to go to the welfare office again looking for food stamps.
Looking for no more food stamps. I'll be eating all the food in her house, gourmet food. She be paying for everything. I said, woman, what else you got for me? You done bought me a car. You done made me plenty of milks and cookies.
Oh.
I done ate all the Oreos, now the chocolate chips. And then you bought me a big old mansion. You paid for my crusty feet to be in your beautiful $100,000 house. Inside is $100,000, the outside is a $2.5 million house. And my dad, he get to sit down with a beautiful woman like Holly Berry.
Holly Berry, yeah.
And she's 22 years old. They make him another baby because he want a baby. If you want a lottery, you ain't got to pay child support. So you know it's going to be Africa Village all over the United States and East Continent by the time he get there. Because he the latest man they know how. And we're preaching the word of God. He'll preach the word of God and he'll be the next Billy Graham out of your money.
out
of her money. She be paying for the trading time. What is it, $60,000 on BL trading?
About $60,000 per episode.
Per episode. You be paying for them per episode for him to say, hello there. May I help you? God's been good. You be paying for that, and he can be paying to be with the latest man of Dayton, Ohio.
Well, that's food for thought. I never thought of it in that way.
So we only have a form of a woman, and she paying for all the bills and paying for our bills.
Okay.
And buying you her mansion and paying for everything and looking like Holly Berry. And if she ugly, she got enough money to fix her face up so she can look like a Holly Berry and make sure you pay for everything out of your pocketbook. Then what happened for you? But if that ain't gonna happen, you just gonna enjoy life and we gonna be here at the welfare office, living struggling. See, I had a welfare car, right? And I went to the grocery store, my dad's a General Motors worker. He said that to me, he says, you get a lot of food. I said, it's free for the government, because I'm broke and unemployed, brother. Next thing you know, I went to the, swipe the card.
Yes.
And dad kind of moved away. I said, what you doing? He said, somebody might know me, my brother. I'm on TV, I'm a religious leader. What you doing? How you doing, Reverend? I hear you got the food stamp card next to the welfare king. They kind of slide away. And then when I get the groceries, I kind of get the groceries and walk on by. It might be Christmas.
Uh-huh.
Mom said she didn't want a Christmas gift for me.
Oh, she didn't?
She said she don't want a Christmas gift for nobody ain't got no money.
Oh.
She said she don't want it. They said that ain't even a gift. And she said I shouldn't be on here talking about I need a woman paying all the bills. She said, women look at you like you ain't going to talk to me. I said, women talk to me because I'm just sexy and good looking.
Oh, is that it?
Called Kathy. Kathy called me. I said, this woman love me. We broke up for about like a month, right?
Uh-huh.
I ain't heard nothing from her. Next thing on the phone ring. I said, she waiting on me because she loved the latest man of Dayton, Ohio.
Oh, Kathy, okay.
And the next thing you know, she said, excuse me. I said, what? I said, can I get some bootleg movies? I said, what?
You mean she called you not to apologize to you,
but because she wanted some bootleg movies.
Some bootleg movies.
I said, ain't that something? You want Spider-Man more than you want me. You want Man in Black for you, more you want me. You want Batman for you want me. Mm-hmm. I don't sell bootleg movies. I just know how I do it as a hobby. So, police, if you watch this, it's a hobby, or it's jokes, whatever you want to say. Now, back to this. We ain't going to be happy with them people, but if y'all want the money, me and Dad be over there. Dad's going to be on training. You pay for everything. Pay for him to be on training. Pay for him to be on limo. Pay for him to be the next Billy Graham or the next Osteen. Don't he look like Osteen in a black version? Looks pretty good to me. He even talk like him. And then next day, you know, buy him a limousine. Ladies, you know he is spectacular. This brother right here, I tell you, you pay all his bills, he will say every day that he love you. And make sure you put them on TV.
I might, not just once a day, I might say it two or three times a day.
Three times a day, like my mother, right? Because I've been divorced once since 1980. Dad, remember the date the last time you had a milk and cookies from her? I said, you remember the day in the month? You remember about the last time y'all had a nice walk? But you remember the last day in 1980 that you had the last milk and cookies?
I vaguely remember, yes.
And you said, and my mother won the lottery. You would propose to her. I told my mother said, I don't need him to marry me. I give him at least $500 if I win the lottery.
How much?
Talking about he ain't got to marry me for no money. That's all. You look awful beautiful again, even though you're arguing with him. Complain, snap your neck, and that's right. He said he the boss. You child four or five times. Who's the boss? I remember one time you was working at General Motors. You work overtime. You went to go get some sleep. She turned out the radio and said, what's going on here? Is this a nightmare? My head looks like it's about to choke somebody. This is the time before you can't preach me. You went to sleep. Ring. You said, woman. Then walked right out. You was mad.
And you remember
that. I remember that. I remember the time when a woman did me like that. I was going to go to work. See, I'm always broke, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I guess I promised her a bill I was going to pay, but I forgot all about it. I started sleeping. 1 o'clock in the morning. somebody hit me. I said, who hit me? I said, I know this must be a nightmare. A woman woke up, looked down at me. I said, what you looking at? I'm asleep. She said, you don't treat me right. You can leave. I said, you don't tell me that now. We just had a good day all day yesterday. I gave her a hug, kiss, and we walked around the park. And then we went to Audis and got some free bologna. She said, you don't do me right. You don't pay no bills. You don't do nothing. I said, woman, I ain't got time for this. I got to go to work. At 7 o'clock in the morning, I can barely keep my eyes up. I can barely get the sleep out of my eye. You going to talk about this stuff now? You talking about stuff that happened 3 months ago, and now you talking about it now? I went back to sleep. Whoop me up. What? You can leave. I said, woman, you do that one more time. You better call 911 and bring the police over here, because by the time I get done with you, I don't know what's going to happen. It ain't nothing brain. She woke me again. I didn't cuss. I was so tired, I could barely drive home. I drove home, mm-hmm. got ready to go to work, and then the supervisor argued with me.
Oh,
and I cussed him out. I was surprised out again. I was fired from there. My whole day was messed up. So if you're broke, you expect these are things you can look for when you're broke and you promise a woman some money. Like I owe the woman some money too. Mm-hmm. Another time, she's about 5'2". You know when you owe a woman money, all of a sudden she look like Hulk King Kong.
And kidding.
And you start hiding from me. Said, you got my money. She start talking to you like a man. You got my money. I said, oh Lord, have mercy. This 5'2" woman, I owe her some money. I got to hide. Disappear.
Well, that, I've heard of situations like that.
Mm-hmm. But like I said, if you got money, my dad all of a sudden fall in love with you. And my mother, he said, you know, your mother's the best black woman I ever had. He like dark women. I said, Lord, have mercy. He a light skinned, but if I was light skinned, I said, I'd be talking to all the women. He like, so if you're dark woman, my dad loved dark women. He does. The darker you are, the better. Me, the more money you got, the better.
Yeah, it's not the color, it's the money.
The money in the pocketbook and the check that she wrote.
Okay, okay.
But my dad, he's the man. You know, sitting ladies. He looked at this one girl. She was about video store. She about like 22 years old. Dad kind of put his hands in the pocket like my cordial. Looked away. He looked at her. She said, this big old man looking at me, dimpling at me. Now y'all say, he should be ashamed of himself looking at her. 21 means you're legal.
Yeah.
Don't ever forget that. He like old ladies like you too. He like it when he can take your pocketbook and you pay his bills. And you cut his grass. He don't want to cut your grass. They don't like me out there cutting the grass. It's too hot to be cutting the grass out there. You pay his bills. You know, he work at General Motors and got a nice check. Like my mother said, you go get $800 extra on your check. Dad said, first my mother's on the phone. My dad said, this remind me back why that's why we divorced today. This year, nurse said, let me tell you, dad said, let me tell you something. Listen to me. Let me tell you something. Hold on, just and then she said, just write the information. Dad wrote the information down. Dad said, I'm going to room get a pen, right? The phone was ringing. She's still talking. I said, this sounds like this is the answering service. What's going on? Next thing, right? Dad picked up the phone. He said, all right, I'll talk to you later. Boom. Then the dad didn't really listen to her because she ran him out too much. Dad don't like a woman to run him out too much because it kind of reminds me of the days called divorce days. So he called and then they said, you get $800 extra. They said, $800. He said, my ex-wife looked very attractive. I think I'm going to listen. His ear got wide open. The ear, the wax, everything started coming out. He said, I listen real good. She said, $800 with my General Motors check. So then he went in and called the people. The rest of the story, you got to find out on your own. But that, he don't like no woman telling him what to do.
That's very true. You might say I'm from the old school. And if you're from the old school,
mm-hmm.
you follow the old rules.
That's right.
And that's one of the commandments of the old school.
Mm-hmm.
We don't like our women to tell us
what to do.
What to do.
Well, listen, but don't come at it like, hey, you better do it. You talk very nice to people like this. I suggest, honey.
Yeah, I like that.
That you do this. And Dad said, well, I'll listen to her because I'm still a hero. But she go, da-da-da-da-da. Dad said, I ain't no hero no more. This is, you strike. Let me put my chest out a little bit. You forget who the boss, who the man is. Don't challenge no man like that.
That's
these all jokes, so don't get too upset. Like I went to work, right? Dad told me don't do this joke because it's so retarded. But everybody at work crying, got tears in their eyes. Maybe you might cry a lot. You might think I'm crazy after this. You might call Dave Monk, lock me up. I might be in a straitjacket and say, this man is totally mental. I'm gonna do this joke and Dad don't like me to do it. It's called the chicken and the Donald Duck. I did the work and my supervisor, he laughed so hard he almost fell down and pee. This is really retarded. I look like a chicken when I do it. You seen that joke?
No.
It's really, really immature. Okay, I was like, it's like a chicken, right?
Are you okay? What was that?
It's called a chicken.
Oh.
Okay, I'll go like this, because this guy, I used to pray with Demond Moore.
Mm-hmm.
I ran with him, he got the chicken, like, and I did that in front of work. And they's like, man, you look like a chicken. They start laughing, right? And then I started sounding like Don. They're like, right?
Okay.
And it's really immature for my age, right?
Yes.
So this other guy said,
immature.
My boss said, you need to make them both argue like it's an exorcist. So the chicken argued with the duck. So I went, they start laughing and crying. So if everybody laughing on TV, this must have been for the car.
I think we may have to make a phone call out to Wayne Avenue if you keep that up.
That dude got a way out there.
It's way, way out there.
They was cracking up on it. They said he looked crazy. Knocked me up and everything else at the welfare office.
Well, I be dog.
Yeah, ladies, we ain't happy for y'all to want Larry this year. Paying dad's bills and paying my bills. We ready. We give you all the whole bills doing in your laps and pay for everything. We put our feet up and relax. You pay for everything.
They might not feel that you really love them if you do that.
I'll be in love with them because I look at my welfare kingdom life.
They might get the impression that you're only with them for the money.
That's all I'm in with them for. What else are they good for? The woman think I'm gonna be with her without no money. And the economy bad too.
Well, that's true. The economy is bad. She doesn't. It takes two in this day and age.
Unless they want a lottery like them, then they gonna take one.
That's true.
I'm doing her a purpose, me walking around with her. Because I look good. I'm bald, blackhead, bald, black, unemployed.
Unemployed.
And what a woman don't want that? Women, y'all looking for danger. A man on a welfare tip, catch the bus.
Mm-hmm.
The green machine bus, walk in the cold, bald head, black man with no money, no benefits, no nothing in your life. That's what you're looking for, and you pay all his bills.
I think there's a scarcity for those kind of men. I think there's a lot of women out there looking for men just like you.
Just like me, and tell a woman that I'm the boss, and don't got no money, ain't paid it for the bills and eat up all her food and eat up all her cereal and she pay for all of it. They're looking for a man like that.
Perhaps you might be right. There might be a scarcity of men just like that.
With just
those
like that.
Qualifications.
Those qualifications, ladies. These are all jokes, so don't take them too serious. That's right. You got anything else to say, Dad? The CEO of Dating People, you didn't take a lot of people, made them famous. You made me famous, too. Now, we go out, people laugh when they see me. They say, man, you a funny man. I said, what's up? When I seen the TV show, I started laughing. You talk about this and that, and that. Then they look at Dad and say, you know, y'all some funny people. We the religious producers and the comedian people. Now we're comedians.
Well, we've been blessed.
We've been blessed.
And I just want to tell our viewers that we greatly appreciate them tuning us in every week. And of course, we would love for you to join us every week at the same time on the same station. And you, do you have anything to tell them?
We appreciate you watching. Continue to watch Dating People. We are still doing taping people on the show. We're doing jokes because people say we're funny, but my woman don't think I'm funny. I don't know why. She listens to every word. I said, do you think the show is funny? She listens. I guess she's living in the welfare dream. Not going to the movies to give her the bootleg CD. She asked for something to eat. I said, I don't know about getting to eat. I give you a cheeseburger and a fry and a water. So when she look at the show, she don't think it's too funny because this is her life story with me.
Her life story, yeah.
I guess when they close to you, they funny, but when they ain't close to you, it's a funny show.
Maybe you may have a point there. That could be the secret of your success. And so, until we meet again, may God bless you and your family.
Oh, man. Oh, here, God, no, make it so worse. And bear. Yep.
Me and my dad gonna pay all your bills, and y'all ain't got to struggle none, because we gonna take care of the women. But we give you all our money. The man to pay your bills. I like paying women's bills. Let's go shopping, ladies. I'm gonna go ahead and buy y'all something. That is out here. All $500 I'll buy y'all what y'all want in this new car.
When a black woman mad and she walk on the, she just got off the bus and she walking downtown to her destination, but she mad, she all good. She don't care if everybody look at her and get mad and all great. When she mad, she is mad. She don't care who listen when she mad. And you know what I'm saying? It could be a priest or a preacher out there. She don't care. She'll say that cuss word. She don't care. When she mad, she mad. And she mad because a black man done messed up because he didn't pay the bill because he lost his money for gambling and he went to the living room or the ham and he lost the rent money. And it's what that black woman say. Hey, baby, he call her. Hey, baby, you know what I'm saying? And she up there walking. She just got in the bus. She man, I'm tired. It's cold out here. It's cold. Any day that black man should be having a job. He need to get a car. So I ain't got to be at the cold. It's cold out here. It's almost 0 degrees. And I'm going to get cold. This black man ain't got no car. And I just got the bus. And you go, hey, baby, you know what? What? You know, baby, you know that money, I lost that money because I went to the living room and the ham and I saw the professional ballerina dancers. And next thing you know, when the professional ballerina dancer gave me a dance, I lost the money because she took my money. You left my money and you went to the ham. Yeah, baby, I'm sorry, but I love you. And I'll be hoping you come home and you cook me something. I ain't cook you nothing, nothing. And everybody look like, what's wrong with that black boy? You better go look at me before I go inside your head. Well, black boy, we're about to fight everybody. It could be a 7 feet tall black man. She said, I go inside your head. You look like my baby daddy. I'm going to go inside your head. You better get my face. What? You with them crusty black feet. You better get my face. And the black man move aside. Then the police come by and say, you better get out my way. Police say, what do you mean, we got my way? You better get out my way. You talking about black lives matter. If we black lives matter, I go inside your head. Get out my way. The police move out the way. And she starts talking about man like this. And you going to get my for what? You can't have a meal. You ain't a real man. You can't run a marathon and your feet stink and you can't take care of the kids. Come on, daddy. Come on.
I got a condo in Manhattan. Baby girl, what's happening? So gone and get to clapping. Go pop it for a plan. Pop it for me. Turn around and drop it for a plan. Drop it for me. I'll rent some beach house in Miami. Wake up with no jammies. Lobster tail for dinner. Julio served that scampi. You got it if you want it. Got it if you want it. Said you got it if you want it. Take my wallet if you want it now. Jump in the Cadillac.
Girl, let's put some miles on it.
Anything you want,
just to put a smile on it.
You deserve it, baby, you deserve it all. And I'm gonna give it to you.
Cool jewelry shining so bright. Strawberry champagne on ice. Lucky for you, that's what I like. That's what I like. Lucky for you, that's what I like. That's what I like. Sex by the fire at night. Silk sheets and diamonds all white. That's what I like. Lucky for you, that's what I like. That's what I like.
I'm talking trips to Puerto Rico. Say the word and we go. You can be my flica. Girl, I'll be a flico mama sister.
I would never make a promise that I can't keep.
I promise that your smile ain't gonna never leave. Shopping sprees in Paris. Everything 24 carats. I take a look in that mirror. Now tell me who's the fairest. Is it you?
Is it you?
Is it me?
Is it me?
Say it's us.
Say it's us.
And I'll agree, baby. Jump in the Cadillac.
Girl, let's put some miles on it.
Anything you want.
Just to put a smile on it.
You deserve it, baby. You deserve it all. And I'm gonna give it to you.
Gold jewelry shining so bright. Strawberry champagne on us.
Lucky for you, that's what I like. That's what I like. Lucky for you, that's what I like. That's what I like.
Sex by the fire at night. Silk sheets and diamonds all white.
Lucky for you, that's what I like. That's what I like. Lucky for you, that's what I like. That's what I like.
You say you want a good time. But here I am, baby. Here I am, baby.
Talk to me, talk to me.
Talk to me, say
yeah.
What's on your mind?
doing on Date People Show. We got the comedian coming in to you. Here we go.
Hey, everybody, how are you going to do? Yeah, I'll tell you about the snapper. Yeah, yeah, it was one time I was living out in my out in the woods, and I was all like, she's like, no, don't do that. And I was like, what if somebody comes up on it? I don't know if it's that.
I'm done.
three of the four guys were hard. They had, it was hard for them to see. They couldn't see anything, and but they'd hit the ball, and the fourth guy had good eyesight, and he would see where the ball went. Well, he died, and they were left. They were left without anybody see where their ball went. So they went to the pro, and they said, "We need somebody who can really see where the balls go, so we can find our balls." And the pro said, "Okay, I get you a guy." Well, they got a guy, and they went out, and they got on the course, and they hit their balls, and they looked at the guy and said, "Did you see where the ball went?" And he goes, "Yeah." He says, "They hit another ball. See where the ball went? Yeah, I saw where it went. See where the ball went? Yeah, I saw where it went." And then they got done. They moved off the tee, and they went out onto the greens, and they said, "Okay, where are our balls at?" And he goes, I can't remember.
I'm going to get your name for the comedians on TV, the next big comedians of the world. And your name is?
Oh. MC Whiting.
All right, so look out for him. I didn't get you on there. Get your name on there. Comedian is?
Bob Clack.
Out there on the Tonight. So on the Tonight Show and all these shows, the next comedian is coming in. All right, see you on the next Date People.
All right, see ya.
See you dating people.
That's how a black man act when he get caught and his old lady driving behind him. She's still behind us. Don't pet it. What? You mean the girl got a knife and she got a girl running with her? We gonna have to leave. Oh man, she coming behind us? Ha ha! Oh, behind us!
Ah! All right. I'm a $5 brother, right? I'm a broke black man with no money. I want a woman to take care of me. See, the black woman don't want no broke black man when they ain't got no money. I'm a broke black man with no money. See, my dream is this. Women, they working now, right? Well, I'm a broke black, but look at my nappy hair, right? I got kinky hair because I can't afford to get a haircut. Right? I'm so broke. When I look out here, they got a picture that broke. See this little spot on my shirt? That's how broke I am because spots be all over my shirt because I'm a broke black brother with no money and no opportunity. And I got $5 black women, and I ain't got no money. Look at my ass. I got a beard. My beard coming because I can't cut my hair. I want you to pay for this. You know what I'm saying? I'm a broke black man with no money and no opportunity at the welfare office. Don't I look like I'm a black man struggling, looking, trying to get a job out here and can't get no job out here. I was feeling good for a minute because I heard Donald Trump say he going to have some jobs. So I went to the welfare office and said, hey, you know what I'm saying? Donald Trump the president now, so I guess I can get me a job. They said, yeah, they got a job right for somebody that they got an education, but you got your GEDs and you better go back to the GET bus and then you get your job flipping the fries. But since you're 44 years old, they got these 60-year-old boys working flipping the fries. I think you go out here and sit on the bench and be a bum. I said, well, that look good to me, as long as you look good, Miss Black Woman, because you give me all this advice at the welfare I was talking about. I can't get no job and I'm struggling. And ain't no good job for a black brother 44 years old. And he think he can run the mail down like this. I said, well, since I can't get a job, I'm going to be a job being your man, being a black man in your house with no money. At the welfare, I was hitting on a woman. At the welfare, I was working at the welfare office, and I got my little $5 on me. And I can't do nothing but be broken black and whole opportunity with this $5 and take it out of there and tell her that I live until it that I need it. A broken black with no money and no opportunity with a beard and Kunta Kinte hair that ain't been cut yet. And I'm going to go here and walk in her house and she's going to marry and love me because she got a job and I don't got a job. And I'm going to rely on the myth. And I'm going to go ahead and make about 4 or 5 Kunta Kinte kids in her house. And she's going to give me the milk of cookies 7 days a week. And I'm going to ruin the mail down like this. And she ain't going to call the police on me. So I said, Miss Black Woman, you know what I'm saying? Since I can't get a job, I'm going to go in and holler at you because you got a job for one. And I'm pretty sure you want an opportunity with a broke black man that looks like me with a beard and kicking Kunta Kinte hair that ain't been cut yet and got a spot on the shirt. Look like I just trying to paint, but I ain't really a painter. I don't even know where the spot come from. Spot come all over me when you ain't got no money. And I'm at the welfare. I was trying to get a job, trying to give me an opportunity, but you said there ain't no opportunity for me. But there's an opportunity for love for me, Miss Black Woman, that work at the welfare office one. And you wanted this. Mr. Black Man, you mean to keep on going? There's other black man as I hit out of employ, trying to get them a job. I said, forget them black brothers right there. I'm trying to start this love connection with you. These black brothers can wait. They were waiting and trying to get a job for a long time. They can't get a job. Now they might as well wait till this black brother trying to get a job being your man at the welfare office and for Melly Love. This black woman said, I'm going to get security because you can't go ahead and talk to me for one. I don't want no man that ain't got no job. I said, I would have had a job if you would have gave me a job. I'm about to whiff off of struggling trying to get a job. And if you would have gave me a job, I could have been your man to take you out to dinner and we both be have a job to get. But she knew, she get mad at me because I ain't got no job. I'm about to whiff off of one. I'm here trying to get a job, right? She said, well, we just don't have no job. Right? Check with next week. I said, I ain't going to check on next week right now. And I'm going to be a real black man with no opportunity. I'm going to hit on this black woman right now because you work at the whiff office. And I'm pretty sure if I need you, you're going to find a job because you're going to make sure that I ain't going to be in your house and don't have no job and get the milk and cookies. So you're going to make sure that I get a job. If I go ahead out here and leave the whiff office right now, I'm going to be next week coming to the whiff office with no job. But if I date the whiff woman at the whiff office is getting a job and looking like you, with the beard and kinky head and looking like I'm struggling with this spot. I don't know where this spot come from because I ain't no painter. And I go ahead and did her and get the milk cooking from her. And I go ahead and give her my big feet. And she gonna buy me some big shoes. And I go ahead and run in her house to mirror the mirror down, run the mirror down like this. And I go ahead and say, hey, baby, I ain't got no money, but I get the milk cookie 7 days a week for the woman at the wheel forever. This fine looking black sister. And I got my $5 because that's the only thing I can afford because I got $5, no $5 money, and no job, and no benefits or nothing. But before that, forward, and living in your house, and you a black woman, and got a nice house. Cause you at the welfare office and you done got you some overtime money and this broke black money at the welfare office. And these other black brothers said, I can't find a job. But I said, that's all right, but I don't need no job because I got the woman that work at the welfare office. One, I'm guaranteed to get a job. Said, yeah, go ahead and date a woman at the welfare office because one thing a black woman don't want, no black man that don't want. I know for a fact. I've been dating women all the time, and since I ain't been working, I've been in the welfare office struggling, catching the bus at the RTA, trying to figure out where I'm gonna go. And I go here, see black women drive the car, and I wave my hand at them, and they go over, because they don't want that type of black man. I look like a black burger struggling, baby, but I ain't gonna struggle them. I said, how you ain't gonna struggle them? I said, baby, you look good. You always tell the black woman, she look good when she get mad. She said, you look good, look at her. You look good, black woman. If you want to go and get you a job, you can date a woman that work at the welfare office. Because there's a whole lot of black women that got a job and work at the welfare office because they like to argue with the black man. Because you know what I'm saying? They don't have a black woman to argue with a black man. One, because they know how to argue with one. So they said, we ain't got no job right now, but come next week. I'm tired of coming next week. I'm going to these bus tokens. I went downtown to the hub. And I got to wait about 30 minutes to get on the bus and then drive out to the welfare office and try to get a job. You're going to tell me to come next week? I ain't coming next week. I'm going to be your man and walk in your house and be struggling. Ugly, and you gonna be ugly, and I'm gonna get the milk and cookies, and you gonna fall madly in love with me, and that's the way it's gonna be. So next thing you know, I'm dating this black woman at the welfare office because she said this black man crazy. I'm gonna get this black man at the welfare office. I'm gonna call the police on him because the black man's in the jail all the time. There's one out of four black men go to jail, so I don't want to be one out of five black men go to jail. So I'm gonna go ahead and date this broke black man with no money because he's that darn desperate to get a job. Maybe he get a desperate to get out of my face. So I go in her house, and her house look good. I'm walking like this. I just got the butter. Yeah, man, I got me a black woman that got a house or something. I'm looking at him. Yeah, ain't got nothing to worry about now. This black woman gonna take care of this black broke black brother with no money and no opportunity with my what? My $5 in my pocket. Right? This black woman got a cable TV and ain't no crackhead named Bobby bootlegging like they do in my neighborhood. My neighbors got bootleg crackhead people bootlegging their cable. They don't pay for Spectra to watch date people show on TV. It used to be called Time on the Cable. They watch it on the bootleg channel. Well, this black woman can afford it because she work at the welfare office, right? And I'm gonna be a talking to this black woman. I said, you do you the offer, girl. She said, you still got that spot of shoe. I said, I'll buy me a new shirt when you buy me a new job so I can buy a new shirt. Right now, I'm struggling. And I put my arm around the woman. And she said, you smell good, but your smell is starting to leave a little bit because you got that $1 deodorant. I said, I'm looking for a $1 deodorant because I'm a dollar, brother. They go to the dollar store. And that's all I can afford is dollar clothes. I can't go to the mall and buy me some clothes at Old Navy. I'm gonna call the Family Dollar, brother. And that's what the shirts are with, Family Dollar. I'm a struggling black man with no money opportunities, right? So I'm in this black woman's house. And next thing you know, I didn't show the Memphis. She for Melon Love, man, for one. And then next thing you know, all them bills start coming because the welfare office said, you know what, Miss Black Woman, we're going to have to make some cuts. She said, what do you mean going to make some cuts for me? You know, another black woman come down. You know, I got to ask you, I don't like you either, but you can get out of here. You're going to take about 2 weeks' notice and you ain't going to get paid. You can get out. Oh, that black woman about to pull that wig out, but security had to pull out my black woman that worked at the welfare office. Next thing you know, she's all worth for 2 weeks. She's broken black like me. So we both black, two black broke people together. And you don't want that when you're a broke black man with no money and your woman lose. losing money. And she looking for you, and next thing you know, the sink start flooding up. I said, well, ain't the sink flooding up. You don't get that fixed. She said, well, I got to get this check because I won't get paid in the next 2 weeks because I'm on probation. I said, you gonna get the money? I said, I ain't getting no money for one unless I hit on another black woman that welfare. I was like, I guess I got to hit on that black woman that put you on suspension so I can go in here and get the money and pay for this sink. And then after I get back with her, I'll break up with her and get back with you. She said, you ain't going to do that. And I make a black woman go ahead and call the police before they call the police, or they get the fine band and start chasing you in the night like that. And I'll be real, lady. So, you don't want to make a black woman mad like that. So when you broke and your woman broke and you're broke and you ain't got no money, you a black man, they expect a black man to go ahead and figure out how to get some money for one. I said, you got that ski mask right there. I think I'm going to go to the bank. But I ain't going to do that for one because next thing you know, when I put the ski mask on, they said, I forgot that my name's on there, David Woods, and they go ahead and lock me up. Say, how they find me? I had that ski mask on with that black brother trying to rob the bank. They had his name, David Woods, that dumb black brother. You better go on to the downtown. I ain't going to Montgomery County Jail for one. I already got Montgomery County Jail. They don't feed you right. This black woman gonna feed me right. So what I told the black woman, I said, we'll make it, baby. I'm going to go out here, and I'm going to go over here and then show the ladies these muscles. So I'm going to have to date some couple women for around, because you know what it is. I'm the latest man that date no high, and I go and get some money. But I ain't going to get the milk and cookies from them. I'm just going to go ahead and get their money and get the money back to you. She said, well, I can deal with that for one. Just as long as you don't get in them, nothing to me. I said, that's all right, baby, because I ain't going to give them the milk. So I need some black women. The only black woman I get is 400-pound black woman. Gonna go ahead and date a black man. Ain't got no money for one. And I said, Miss, 400-pound black woman, I love it. She said, you love me, but because I gained more weight, I was 500 pounds. I said, 500 pounds, good. Lord, you gonna get that money in my pocket. So next day, you know, I got another $5 in my pocket. I walk in that black woman. You know, she went back to work. She went ahead and found me a job. I said, doggone it, she can find me a job. I was enjoying this living in her house. Put my crusty black feet in her house. And she up there working. Now I got to go. Now I got to go to work because now the welfare offered to find me a job for one, and she didn't want to find me a good job, so she ain't got to never worry about when she gets suspended for 2 weeks that she got to go ahead and struggle. And I got to talk to another one, said, you ain't gonna never talk to another one for one, because I'm gonna make sure you're gonna find a job, and this job is permanent. You don't work like a dog 60 days a week. I said, 60 days a week, that's a whole lot of work. I ain't got enough time to spend my arm around you. So you can spend your arm later on, but one, you gonna pay these bills, because I ain't gonna be able to wait for hours one forever. I got a career going living off the black man. I said, you gonna live with the black man? I'm trying to live off the black woman. So, oh, that ain't work no more, because that black woman start going inside with that fair man like and I've been running like that. So you don't tell a black woman what you really think. You tell her you want to work. I said, I'm a black brother, like to work. I'm trying to hustle something. But you tell a black woman you ain't trying to work and you're dealing without the black woman, I guarantee you're going to go outside your head or she's going to call the police. And the police are going to say, I know the dumb black brother didn't go ahead and tell the black woman that he ain't going to want to work. I can't tell the woman to go lay there that I don't want to work for one. That's why I'm a police officer right now. That's why I go ahead and go to work every day. You think I want to clock in to work? I'm going to be laid feet in her house and go ahead and have the woman call lady and tell her to go ahead to work. And if I do that, next thing you know, she be calling the police on me. Then he know that. I didn't know that for one. I thought all I had to do was go ahead and live with a black woman and go ahead and show them my feet, and I ain't got nowhere about you. They said, you gonna learn real quick, real quick. We got to sell for you, Mr. Broke Black Man. And there's a lot of black brothers up here talking the same story. He said, let me give you a tour of the jail. So I'll go on a tour of the jail, right? I'm making these jokes up right now. I ain't even thinking about the jokes up. You're laughing. I must be truly funny. So I ain't even thinking this stuff. I ain't wrote this stuff down. This coming out the top of my head. I don't even know what I'm saying. I'm just saying it's in the day, and it's coming out funny. So I'll go to the jail, right? If you got the talent, you can do jokes like that. You ain't got to write it all the time. So I'm going to jail. Right? I'm saying this joke, and I don't even know what I'm saying. So I'm going to jail, right? And I say, hey, brother, what you doing? This black brother, yeah, man, I'm going to be on. I told my old lady, I'm a broke black man with no money or opportunity. And I ain't going to pay no bills. I said, how for you, my brother? I said, why you down here? I said, I ain't going to pay no bills. The next thing I know, I'm paying the bill, and I'm going to kind of jail. The man said, you ain't going to go ahead and insult this woman, talk about you going to be in her house. She cooking and clean and doing everything for you, and you ain't paying no bills. And nigga, you know. The police come down. I'm down. I'm going to jail. I said, how for you, my brother? But I'm about to leave out here because I'm going to go ahead and get a job. Tell this woman I'm gonna work for about 2 days at Taco Bell, and that's gonna move your body. So she's gonna get off my back for a minute. So I tell her I'm gonna work about 2 days at Taco Bell, and that's it. She said, you ain't gonna work no 2 days with Taco Bell. I got deep in the vet for one. If you want the milk cookies, you're gonna have to go ahead and work a little harder than that. And I said, I ain't gonna go ahead and work no harder than that because you got you a job. You know, when you first met me, I said, baby, you knew when you first met me, I was at the welfare office. You know, you with no money and nothing, and now you want me to have something. That's what tripped me about women. Women want you to have something you didn't have nothing, but then they expect you, they got a dream that a man ain't got nothing, gonna have something in the future, and they wanna fall in love with that brother. But they want to go back to the brother they didn't have. I said, why'd you go with me in the beginning? She said, I wanted you in the beginning because I was afraid of you, and I don't want to call the police on you. So I went ahead and dated you, and I found out that I like you. But now I'm starting not to like you because you want to stay there. But I thought you going to go ahead and wear a suit and tie and quit looking like this broke black brother with no money and no opportunity relying on me. But I got a whole lot of black brothers trying to call me and trying to give me and talking about they the big black brother with a black brother with money and got everything. I said, woman, I ain't got no money for one. I got my $5. I'm going to go ahead and get the milk cookie 5 days a week, 7 days a week. My $5, you going to go ahead and work, and I ain't got I do nothing but live in your house, my crusty black feet in your house, and next thing you know, she got to call the police, and I'll be real like that. These all jokes. Now let me get down to the real thing. Because I go in here and say this joke, right? See, it comes to my head. I don't know what I'm saying, but it's funny. I come with jokes all the time. People laugh. If I go ahead and you think one time you turn this station talking about this black brother, I ain't got no money, ain't got no opportunity. If I see that black brother, he try to holler at me, I ain't going to talk to him later. You know, I'm just joking around because I got some money for one. You know what I'm saying? I went ahead and look like I'm a broke black brother for nothing because I'm trying to look like this because I always look like this. But look at this. Put on all that money, girl. You know I can pay your own bills, black woman. You think I'm gonna go ahead and do these jokes and be really broke for real? There ain't no funny about that. It's funny when you got the money and you act like you ain't got no money. I say, black woman, I got this money. And I go, like, I ain't got no money. Get a milk of good business for free. And I look like this. Then she find I got the money. She be getting a gun and go like that. So the moral of the story is this. Don't go ahead and act like you ain't got no money when you got some money. Because she find out you ain't got some money and you going like, I ain't got no money. Then she find out you got some money. The black woman gonna go get a fry pan like this. Or get a gun and shoot you like that. That's the moral of the story for one. But ladies, I go ahead and pay your bills. That's how me and my dad do. We the latest men that didn't know how we do jokes. This is a joke show. Putting all that money for your black woman out here. So you want me to go ahead and pay your bills and I'm looking like a broke black woman with no money, but I really got the money. See, I don't wear no suit and tie. I want to look broke and black. So I can see, you can see how I really look. I get tired of buying them suits. I want to look like I'm broke and black and got some money. And that's called a black brother that want to look broke and got some money. I only pull the money out when you're about to leave me. And then when you with me, I look like I'm broke and black. So you can be a little bit. And then when you're about to call the police, I pull the money out so I won't have to go to jail. And that's the moral of the story.